What's up, YouTube? It's Eclipse here, and I'm taking y'all with me today so y'all can see the life of a mobile barber. First stop today is in Odessa, Texas, which is about 30 minutes from where I stay. I'm on the road right now. There's some traffic, but first customer, I've been cutting his hair for about 2 or 3 months now. He reached out to me on Facebook. After the first time cutting his hair, he's been booking me every 2 weeks since. I actually go to his job site. He's a real good customer of mine. You know, as a barber, your customers tend to turn into friends. I call this guy a good friend of mine as well. Anyways, I'm on the way right now to the first stop. Y'all stay tuned, and I'll let y'all know how the rest of my day goes. Hey.
Hopping in, bitch, and I start the V. Snakes in the grass, so they harder to see. My brother would give up his life to the O. He told me he'd go be a martyr for me. Said that she ready to corner the six. I hit up Pauline to charter the P. Ain't really Lee, but I'm back. I'm back. I'm back. I'm riding around in Atlanta with Sav, cause that nigga been going harder than me. Nothing to change, I'm just harder to please. Ferrari is making an SUV. We ain't got a choice, we ordering these. Shout out Noel for recording the V's. He know where this shit about to go. Cause nobody touching the flow. They say you alone at the top, but it's gotta be lonely below. You boys getting ready to diss, but don't even mention the O.
That's it for stop number one. My client was very happy with the service. Like I said, I pulled up to his job. He walked out. I had him in and out in about 40 minutes. Clients, they pay for conveniency, you know? The fact that the barber's coming up and they got a complete barber station is something that they really like. I just gotta clean my things now, and I'm off the way to my second location. Y'all stay tuned.
Next spot, about 19 minutes away.
So, let's do it.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Yeah. Check this out. I get mad zooted, I got this bad thing I recruited. My passion is a movie, I say fuck her cause I screwed her. I stay on Miley Cyrus, everywhere I go I'm screwed up. I know my Texas niggas got my back and that's for sure though. Sipping on Instagram like Tiny Rain.
Here, we just pulled up to the second location. I'm actually doing 2 clients here at this spot. My first time customers, they reached out to me on Instagram. But initially, they said they found me on TikTok, which I'm not really on TikTok like that. So, you know, I guess the little content I am posting has been helping. Anyways, they found me on TikTok, went to my Instagram, reached out to me through Instagram. So I'm here now. It's 2 brothers, I believe. But, you know, I'm excited. I'm here on time. I'm excited just to give these guys experience that they're paying for, you know? So y'all stay tuned.
Hey, tell me who that nigga if it ain't me. If it ain't a party, then it's finna be.
Like that, man, we're done with those pretty easy haircuts for the most part. They both just wanted high tapers and just, you know, clean up the facial hair and whatnot. So it didn't take too much time of my day. I pulled up to their house. They're both enjoying their day off. And, you know, they reached out to me and wanted to get the experience of a barber coming to their house. And yeah, man, it's what I provide. I provide conveniency, I provide quality. Enjoy what I do. It's really helped me take my service to the next level, you know what I mean? Anyways, we're done here. My next stop is back in Odessa. You know, it doesn't always work out. It doesn't always happen that I have to go back and forth from Odessa and Midland. But today it worked out that way and I'm not complaining. You know, I enjoy the time I get to be on the road, listen to music or a podcast. And you're calling my wife, calling the kids, whatever it may be. I enjoy that 20, 30 minute break that I feel like I get to sit down even. Yeah, man, we're on the way. All right, guys, so I stopped here at a King Quick just to get some fuel and just a couple snacks for the body. I'm not filling up tank right now, so I'm not gonna show you about how much it is. I'll do that for another video, but just gonna show you a couple of snacks I got. Water, protein shake, Uptime, sugar-free, mango pineapple. That's it, bar, a protein. Some fuel for the body, some fuel for the whip. Check it out, man, advertisement. I get asked all the time when I'm pumping gas if I'm really a barber and this is really a barbershop. I gotta tell them yes. You wanna see? Surprisingly, nobody's really around me right now. One day I'll catch it in action. Going to my third location. He's waiting at me right now. I'm about 5 minutes from his house. And then, yeah, stay tuned.
I'm on a new level. I'm on a new level. I'm on a new level. I'm on a new level.
I'm up here, halfway done with my day. Somebody else called, so I'm booking another one. I'm finishing my day back in Midland. I think it's my last time coming to Odessa, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, man, I'm done here. On the way back to my next one. Shout out to Sean, he blessed me today. It actually worked out because he got called into work today. So the fact that I came to pull up on him was convenient for him. It's about a 30-35 minute drive from here to the shop. So, you know, I saved him a lot of time by me coming here. And for that, he left me a really good tip, man. And I appreciate it. But yeah, back to the middle of my goal. Y'all stay tuned. We're here, guys. Next stop. Should be easy cut. I believe it's a little boy. Just got out of school. So there's a small window from him getting out of school and going to, I believe, football practice. So this is just a convenient way to get a haircut. You know, I'm the guy they call for me to meet them at their house. That way he doesn't have to go to a barbershop. You know what I mean? Little things like that is why I do what I do.
Yeah. Penny X.
I need someone to be patient with me. Someone to get money when I take it from me. They don't even need to be as famous.
I just finished up here. That cut was quick. It actually took me like 25, maybe 30 minutes to hit little man up. Like I said, he had to go to football practice. So he had like an hour window after school to come eat, you know, get ready for practice, get a haircut, all that. So I got him in and out, 25 minutes. He has plenty of time to go in there, hit some Fortnite up or whatever he got to do. I got about 3 clients left in the day. I'm heading to my next one now. Luckily, it's in Midland. I think it's like 15 minutes down the street, but I'm on the way now, so stay tuned. I actually forgot that my next 2 clients have beards, so I just got some towels ready. Put them in the hot towel warmer. As a mobile barber, you know, the van's always moving and stuff, so you gotta make sure you got stuff secured. Same thing with my Lascos, you know what I mean? Have my IVAC down here. Same thing, it's my dirty towel drawer. But yeah, make sure everything's secured. Got the hot towels cooking up. And yeah, let's go to the next appointment.
Got a little update on my next appointment for the day. Just asked if I can pull up to the shop and cut his hair outside the barbershop. You know, that's typically his routine. I didn't have any more openings for the 2 days that I am in the shop. Like I said, he just asked if I could pull up to the shop. So that's what I'm doing now. It's kind of cool. I'm pulling up to the barbershop. He's right outside right here waiting for me. Gives me a chance to come and check on the guys as well. As soon as I finish cutting his hair, I'm gonna stop by the shop, say what's up to everybody, see who's here chopping up on a Tuesday. We're here though. Barbershop's right here. They're in there grinding. I don't know who's in there, but I'm gonna come around. Y'all are ever in Midland, y'all come check out Garelli's right here. Real good Mexican food. I'm gonna come back around, park this big body. Someone back here, so I'm not disturbing anybody. Like I said, he's gonna hop in. And look, he's right there in that truck. But yeah, man, if y'all ever in Midland, Texas, or Odessa, Texas, y'all come by the Garage Barbershop. Posting up right here. But y'all stay tuned.
Made a distribution. Picture labels call me. Bad Bunny numbers, it's a robbery. 500 million just for Aubrey. Yeah, major distribution, high popping. Mention me to be the hottest topic. Same place you send your bitches shopping. Okay, go stupid.
Been a long day. It's about 6:45 here. Overall though, I've been making pretty good money today. Once I'm done with my last cut, I'm gonna go ahead and count everything up and let y'all know exactly how much I made for the day in the life of a mobile barber. This next one's about 15 minutes away. You know, I should be home at a pretty decent time. My girl probably want me home right now, but you know, we gotta hit it when we can, you know what I mean? So y'all stay tuned, man. And we're gonna break down the day, all right? Let's check in with the guys, man. See what the squad is doing.
More money, more problems. More guns, more violence. I beat a couple cases. I feel like John got it. How about a Benz, baby? I feel like God life. I feel like taking some drink right now and pouring it over my niggas. We ain't never turned down.
2:30, baby, won't you meet me by the beans? Too early, maybe later, you could show me things. You know what it is whenever I visit. Windy City, she blowing me kisses, no. 30 degrees, way too cold, so hold me tight. Will I see you at the show tonight? Will I see you at the show tonight?
Hey. Truck to the plane, to the truck, truck to the hotel lobby. Me, I go through underground garages, presidential suite on deposit. Elevator up to the room, shower up and then we hit the club. Touchdown, gotta see what's up. Area code in my phone, what numbers do I still have? Who do I know from the past? Hit one, she say she got a man. Hit another one, it goes green. Must have changed foes on the team. Remember when you let me in between? That was 2000.
All right, YouTube, that's it for my first vlog. Wanted to show you guys a day in the life of a mobile barber. As you guys can see, it's a lot of traveling, a lot of going back and forth between cities, between locations. Overall, I had a good day. I think I did 7 haircuts and 6 different locations. Counted up all the money I made today, about 830 bucks. Today, like I said, off 7 haircuts. So overall, good day. I spent a little bit more time at the barbershop with the guys than originally planned. So it's caused me to run a little bit late. I think it's, what time is it? It's like 8, it's like 8:30 over here. But overall, great day. Customers were happy. A lot of my cuts came out real good. And looking forward to doing these vlogs a lot more often. If you're not following me on Instagram, check me out, e.clips_. I was a full-time barber for about 8, maybe 9 years. I'm 27 right now. I owned a barbershop for 4, going on 5 years. And I've recently been going mobile the last about 4 months. And it's been a journey. It's been a journey, just to say the least. Definitely have enjoyed myself. I've enjoyed the struggles and the overall process of getting to where I'm at right now. Overall, the money's great. I think the most I've made in a single day already has been about 1,200. You know, and I started about 7 a.m., finished about 7 or 8 p.m., you know, 9 p.m., I think. I was constantly posting and promoting myself and the barbershop. Being a shop owner, you still gotta make sure your guys are happy and your guys are taken care of back at home base. So I think I posted about 4 or 5 times today, whether it been on my story or actually making a post on social media, just to kind of keep traffic
flowing in. You know, as I travel further, and sometimes I make more with less cuts, you know. So y'all stay tuned. I want y'all to see firsthand the struggles of being a mobile barber. Ooh, and the success. It's not all about struggles, you know what I mean? I didn't take too many L's, so sometimes it's good to look back, and sometimes it's good to appreciate the dubs. I think today was a dub. 840 bucks, 7 haircuts, you know, and I was really sitting down a lot of my day. I didn't even break a sweat. But here we are, man. I'm inside the shop, the mobile van right now. I'm signing out, man. Peace. Daddy.